Hello students, today we discuss about skewness. First of all, we define the meaning of skewness. Skewness means lack of symmetry. That means we know about the shape of given data. What is the skewed? Positively skewed, negatively skewed, symmetrical curve. We study the skewness. Before skewness, we study the measure of central tendency, measure of dispersion. In both cases, we don't know about the shape of curve. So, if we want to know about the shape of curve, we must study skewness and kurtosis. Today, we discuss about skewness. So, skewness means lack of symmetry, that means shape of the curve. Skewness can be positive as well as negative skewness. Is positive skewness is positive if the longer tail of the frequency curve in right hand side, then this is called positive skewed. And is the longer tail in the left side, then we say that this is negatively skewed. And in skewness, we also study the symmetrical distribution. If any frequency distribution is symmetric, then its frequency are symmetrical. In symmetrical distribution, both side of the center of the point frequency curve. If the point in the center of this point, both side, this side and this side, the curve shape are the same. This is called symmetrical curve. We can say that these are mesochordic or symmetrical curve or a normal curve. Skewness distribution, symmetrical is called skewed distribution. If frequency distribution is not symmetrical, then we say that this is skewed distribution. The curve, frequency curve, is skewed. It may be positive or it may be negative skewed. Positively skewed, this shape of the positive skewness. In this skewness, mean is greater than mode and median is always lie between them. This is the mean value, this is the mode value. Mean is greater than mode in the positively skewed. The shape of the curve is longer tail in the right hand side, then we say that it is positively skewed. In next slide, if the longer tail in the left hand side, this side, then we say that this is the negatively skewed distribution. In this case, mode is greater than mean. Mode is greater than mean. And median is lie between them. So these are the two skewed distribution, positively and negatively skewness distribution. Now we discuss about the moderately symmetrical distribution. In a frequency distribution, the interval between the mean and median, approximately 1/3 of the interval between the mean and mode. This is the main points. Mean and median is approximately 1/3 part of the difference between mean and mode. The distribution is called moderately symmetrical distribution, and we say that this is equal to mean minus median. Difference between mean and median is 1/3 of mean minus mode. So we say that the formula is generated from moderately symmetrical distribution. Mode is equal to 3 median minus 2 mean. Now, test of skewness. To check whether a distribution is skewed or not, the following test can be applied. First one is, the value of mean, median and mode do not coincide. If mean, median, mode lie on a single point, this is called symmetrical distribution and there is no skewness. Quartile are not equidistant from the median. Quartile division, quartile, first quartile Q1 and third quartile Q3, both are not equidistant from the median. This is called, if both quartile 1 and quartile 2, both lie from the median in the same distance from the median, then this is symmetrical distribution. So we say that on the basis of quartile, we say that the skewness or not skewness. Frequency are not symmetrical distribution distributed on both side of the curve point frequency curve. Fourth one, the graph of the given distribution is bell shaped. The graph of the given distribution is bell shaped. If this is the bell shaped, then we say that this is the symmetrical distribution. In next slide, measure of skewness. This is the more important part, and find the skewness. We measure the skewness from two methods, absolute method and relative methods. Absolute methods based upon the mean, median and mode. Second one based upon quartiles Q1 and Q2, Q3. These are the three quartiles. First one is mean, median, mode, and second one is based upon quartile. These are the absolute measure of skewness. Relative measure of skewness, these are four part: Karl Pearson's, Boole's coefficient of skewness, Kelly's and coefficient of skewness based on moments. So Karl Pearson, Boole's, Kelly and coefficient based on moments. Through moments we can also find the skewness through moments. Now we discuss about one by one. First of all, we define the absolute measure of skewness based upon mean, median and mode. Skewness mean minus mode, skewness mean minus median, based upon quartile deviation SQ, SK. These are denoted SK skewness, SK for skewness. Q3 plus Q1 minus 2 Q2. Q2 here represent the median, mid value of the data, and this is called Q2. So we can say that Q3 plus Q1 minus 2 time of median also. Now limitation of the absolute measure of skewness. The skewness computed by using any one of the above measure is expressed in the unit of value of the distribution, and hence we cannot complete the skewness of another distributions expressed in the different unit. So this is the limitation of skewness, measure of skewness, absolute measure of skewness. Now relative measure of skewness, first one is Karl Pearson, second is Boole's, and third one is Kelly's, and fourth one is coefficient of skewness based upon moment. Now we discuss about Karl Pearson coefficient of skewness, which are based upon mean, median and standard deviation. This is the formula of skewness, SKP. We represent here SKP, that means skewness of defined by Pearson's. So SKP is mean minus mode upon standard deviation. This is the formula of Karl Pearson coefficient, and Karl Pearson coefficient of skewness lie between minus 1 to 1. Particular cases we discuss about the some results on skewness defined by Pearson's. If skewness is equal to 0, then we say that mean minus mode is upon standard deviation is also equal to 0. So mean minus mode is 0, and we say that mean is equal to mode. If mean is equal to mode, then we say that both point lie on same point, both value lie on the same point. So we say that this is the symmetrical distribution. In symmetrical distribution, mean, median and mode, both all the three values lie on the same point. Thus distribution is symmetrical. Second one, if greater than 0, skewness is greater than 0, then mean minus mode is upon SD is equal greater than 0. So we can say that mean is mode, and we already discuss about mean is greater than mode when skewness is positively. If positively skewed is greater than 0. Similarly, distribution is negatively skewed if and only if mean minus mode upon standard deviation is less than 0. So we say that skewness of Pearson is less than 0, then we say that these are negatively skewed. So symmetrical distribution, when skewness value is equal to 0, positively skewness is skewness coefficient of skewness is greater than 0, and negatively skewed when skewness of Pearson's less than 0. Now we calculate the skewness. So we take a example of skewness. These are the example. Calculate Karl Pearson coefficient of skewness from the data given below. These two example are also based on skewness by Pearson's, but we discuss about this example in point of exam. The Karl Pearson coefficient of skewness is given by mean minus mode upon standard deviation. We first calculate the mean, mode and standard deviation of this given data. So कैलकुलेशन ऑफ मीन, मीन वी यूज द शॉर्टकट मेथड एंड ए प्लस वन अपॉन एन समेशन आई वेरिंग फ्रॉम वन टू एन एफ आई यू आई वेर यू आई इज इक्वल टू एक्स माइनस ए. सो दिस फार्मूला यूज वी यूज शॉर्टकट मेथड टू फाइंड द मीन एंड पुटिंग ऑल दिस वैल्यू इन दिस फार्मूला एंड वी गेट मीन इज 3.28. दीज आर द मीन एंड कैलकुलेशन ऑफ मोड. मोड वी नो दैट मोड इज द वैल्यू ऑफ द वेरिएबल इन विच हैज़ मैक्सिमम फ्रीक्वेंसी. इन दिस फ्रीक्वेंसी टेबल वी सी दैट दीज आर द मैक्सिमम फ्रीक्वेंसी. मैक्सिमम फ्रीक्वेंसी इज 30. सो मोड इज 3. मोड ऑफ द इज मोड ऑफ द गिवन डाटा इज 3 बिकॉज मैक्सिमम फ्रीक्वेंसी इज 30 एंड कॉरस्पॉन्डिंग द मार्क्स इज 3. सो वी से दैट मोड इज 3. नाउ कैलकुलेशन ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड डाइवेशन फार्मूला. स्टैंडर्ड डाइवेशन फार्मूला वी डिस्कस अर्लियर इन मेजर ऑफ डिस्पर्जन. सो दिस इज द फार्मूला फॉर स्टैंडर्ड डाइवेशन एंड पुटिंग ऑल दिस वैल्यू फ्रॉम दिस टेबल वी कैलकुलेट ऑल दिस वैल्यू फ्रॉम द टेबल एंड पुट इन दिस एंड वी गेट 1.3496. नाउ वी हैव मीन. मीन इज दिस. मोड मोड इज दिस एंड स्टैंडर्ड डाइवेशन इज दिस. पुटिंग ऑल दिस थ्री वैल्यू इन स्क्वीनस बाय पियर्सन्स मीन माइनस मोड अपॉन स्टैंडर्ड डाइवेशन एंड कैलकुलेशन ऑफ दिस इज इक्वल टू 0.2074 द स्क्वीनस. नाउ द वैल्यू ऑफ स्क्वीनस इज 0.2074 एंड विच इज ग्रेटर देन 0. इफ ग्रेटर देन 0 स्क्वीनस इज ग्रेटर देन 0 then we say that these are the positively skewed and on the behalf of this coefficient of skewness we say that the shape of the curve of this given data is positively skewed and the tail of the given data in right hand side this is the shape in this shape the tail of in right hand side these are the positively skewed. So similarly, if data is given in next example is continuous data, then we take the mid values in place of x, these and f. Similarly, we find the mean, mode, mode for using this formula, L plus fm minus f1 to fm minus f1 minus f2 into h. This formula we earlier discussed in measure of central tendency and for standard deviation we use this formula and find all the three values. Here mean is this, mean of the data is 24 and mode of the data is 24.69 and standard deviation is 11 point something and skewness of Pearson's, coefficient of skewness of Pearson's is minus 0.062. Here coefficient of skewness by Pearson's is equal to negative. So we say that these are less than 0. So less than 0 we say that this is the negatively skewed. The shape of the curve in this data in this form. The tail of the curve in left hand side. So skewness is by Pearson is less than 0. So we say that these are the negatively skewed. So on the basis of coefficient of skewness, we can discuss the shape of the curve. So thank you. These are the coefficient of skewness.